Hi, I'm Jordan from Katie, joining from the International AIDS Conference here in Montreal, AIDS 2022. Current HIV treatments are so effective that with early treatment initiation and regular adherence, a person can expect to live a long and healthy life with no chance of passing it on through sex. But what if people face barriers to taking their medication consistently? One new approach to addressing this is long-acting injectable formulations of HIV medications. I spoke to Professor Chloe Orkin at Queen Mary University London to find out more.
Hi, I'm Professor Chloe Orkin, and I work at Queen Mary University of London. Long-acting treatment is needed because we still haven't got to zero, and the reason we haven't got to zero in countries with a good cascade of care is that not everyone feels that they can engage with treatment, and there's some people that cannot or won't take oral therapy. Some people find it intensely stigmatizing and an awful reminder of having HIV that they need to take daily treatment, and some people find it very inconvenient. Some people find it hard to swallow and some find it harder to remember. So there's a whole plethora of reasons why somebody may wish to take long-acting therapy. And it fits into the landscape in that it's been shown to be as effective as daily oral therapy. So it's an alternative, a viable alternative for people who wish to take treatment 2 monthly in Canada or any of the countries in which it's available. Long-acting antiretroviral therapy at the moment consists of cabotegravir and rilpivirine given 2 monthly. And this is being given both for treatment and for pre-exposure prophylaxis. And it's an option that is desirable for many people who wish not to take daily tablets. And at this conference, there's quite a lot of data that's going to be, is being shared. This morning, we heard the data on PrEP in the women's study, the 084 study, in terms of outcomes, and we found that actually it reduced 89% of infections in women, which is a pretty amazing result. In terms of treatment, there's quite a lot of data here. We are seeing the results of the CARUSEL study, the efficacy results of the CARUSEL study, which is a large study in Europe of implementation of cabotegravir or rilpivirine, and it showed excellent outcomes in terms of virological efficacy. We've also seen the CARLOS study, which is the real-world study evaluating cabotegravir or rilpivirine in Germany, and what we've seen is the preferences of the people who are receiving it and their healthcare professionals. We've also seen some data from the SOLAR study, which is looking at the use of the oral lead-in in cabotegravir or rilpivirine. And then there's some data on a drug that isn't yet licensed called lenacapavir in terms of the resistance profile. So there's a lot to hear and a lot to see. So at the moment, we have, in terms of what treatment people may take in the future, we have a large number of modalities. We have amazing modalities with which to deliver therapy. These include long-acting injections, we have implants, we have vaginal rings, which can actually deliver both prevention for HIV and contraception and potentially prevention for other diseases, which is an incredible possibility and it's being actively worked on. Implants in general, potentially as a technology, and potentially nano suspension of oral tablets, so long acting oral therapy, so really coming full circle. The difficulty is that in order to utilize these strategies, what we really need is 2 active drugs which work for a similar length of time. And we have this in cabotegravir and rilpivirine, but what we really need is partners for the other drugs. Drugs such as lenacapavir, which can be given around 6 monthly if it's given as an injectable agent, or potentially monthly as a long-acting oral therapy. We need partners for these regimens. And there are a number of potential partners, but we're not 100% clear what's happening with islatravir, which was the intended partner, and we're not sure because the FDA holds on the trials. So we're waiting to hear on that, whether that will continue to be a partner for lenacapavir. But there are other agents in the pipeline, such as maturation inhibitors, such as broadly neutralizing antibodies, and such as the MK8507 molecule, which is an NNRTI and is still potentially being developed. So I think that's a summary of where we are right now. Well, in countries like Canada, you have the drug available. And I think it's just around continued pressure to explain that HIV is not over. There's still people who need to be treated. And until every single person is treated, we still have an HIV epidemic. So it's also about philanthropic and sort of outreach from countries that can afford it to support other countries elsewhere to make sure that we, as an interconnected world, can make sure that everybody has access to treatment.